Let me go to Steve Sarkisian, named here as an offensive analyst. What do you think about Alabama adding another piece of the USC puzzle here in Tuscaloosa?
Oh, I think they're setting up for the post-Saban era. My first initial thought is, you know, there you go. Saban's old. He's not going to hang around there for forever. Let's say he, bolts for the NFL.
Now, hold on a minute. Hold on a minute, Pete. Are you trying to stir up my audience here 20 minutes into the show? I mean, you called Saban old.
You know, Nick Saban's not going to be the Alabama head coach for forever.
Hold on. I mean, you don't think this guy can go at least 10 more years?
Why would he want to? You're Nick Saban.
He's winning championships. He's in Tuscaloosa. We've got barbecue.
Yeah, but you know what? He didn't do it in the NFL. And no matter how much we love Nick Saban, I love college football, it ain't the NFL. And it just, if you're that guy with an NFL background and you had your one moment in the NFL, it didn't work out so hot, these coaches are weird. I mean, it's just not the same. Saban isn't Bill Belichick. He's not an NFL Super Bowl winning head coach. I still think there's going to be, someone's going to say at some point, hey, Cleveland Browns, whoever it might be, hey, Saban, give this one more shot. And at some point, I think he's going to be, what else can I do here with this gig? At the very least, if you're Lane Kiffin, there you go. Getting Steve Sarkisian is part of the mix as well. Now Alabama has two of college football's, better head coaches as assistants. Those two guys, you're talking USC-level head coaches. Those guys could coach just about anywhere else, and I think you've got everything in place that if this thing keeps on rolling, there you go. Next coach up, Lane Kiffin. Boom.
Man, you're trying to fire up my audience, man. I mean, let me just invite you guys to hammer Pete on Twitter, right? It's at Pete Futak. I mean, you're
it's
saying
not my fault.
You're why saying Saban's going to go to the NFL at some point?
Why
come on.
Why wouldn't he?
Because he's competing for the greatest of all time. I mean,
so what? He's already kind of there. I mean, what else? I mean, what else can he do? He's already being hailed as probably the greatest of all time. You can only do so. And here's the problem with Saban's situation. As great as Alabama is, still got to go to Tennessee, still got to go to LSU, still got to go to Ole Miss. Alabama's better than all three of those teams. But other than the one year, they've only been totally undefeated on one season undefeated under Saban. You get one extra loss, 10-2. All of a sudden, your season's a total failure. And that's just a lot of pressure to try to deal with. And again, you got to understand how coaches work. And these guys, again, being the greatest college football coach of all time, great. He's already probably there. Again, made the NFL.
I mean, his legacy is already established. I mean, I'll go there with you there. I mean, it is established. I mean, he's got a statue out, and they'll probably at some point name this Saban Field at Bryant-Denny Stadium at some point, name a road after him. Man, you give me a lot to think about. I mean, here we are on this high horse coming off of USC, and now you're going to be talking about Saban going to the NFL. But
he's going to stop coaching at some point. I mean,
it's waking us up from this daydream.
Here's the other part of this thing. When it does end, and if you look at when dynasties stop, it's either because there's a major scandal that puts an end to it, like it was at USC under Pete Carroll or at Miami, or just becomes way too, something slips. There's just one little, one recruiting class that isn't quite perfect. One little slip, like Florida State under Bobby Bowden, we make one kind of misfire on your offensive coordinator call. You lose like a Mark Rich type. Or, sometimes, again, you lose two games and that's it. That's it. That's end of dynasty type of season. So at some point, this thing is going to have to sort of, take another step forward. But right now, yeah, Alabama's the number one team in the country, and
you have to admit, I mean, you got to look at the SEC West here. I mean, you've got Les Miles about to go through a transition there at LSU. You've got Gus over at Auburn. They're flapping in the wings. You've got Ole Miss about to go through some major sanctions. We don't know what's going to happen to Arkansas. I mean, he's sitting here at the top of college football in the SEC West going, all right, you guys are playing for second place.
And Alabama could lose to any of those teams. You know that. As weird and funky as this weekend was, and as bad as the SEC looked this weekend, you're telling me that Brett Bielema's team is not being able to at least hang with Alabama. And on the right day, if you have another one of those Ole Miss moments like last year, where everything doesn't go quite right, again, a couple of funky road games, Tennessee's still really good. Let's see if they bounce back from this LSU's still going to be really dangerous on November 5th. You know, I'm saying, you know, right now, obviously, you know, Alabama's number one team in the country, but I think people are saying, all right, well, that's another national championship. SEC, even after this week, still going to be pretty good.
All right, Pete. I mean, I guess I'll slip you $100, man, for stirring up the pot. I mean, it's
I can't say. I told you all last year that Alabama was, you know, national.
Yeah, but you're telling us that Saban's going to go to the NFL. I mean, you're.
I know. I'm telling you that at some point, Nick Saban is not going to be the Alabama head coach.
I mean, what is that point? 5 years down the road? 2 years down the road? I mean, you sound like it's going to happen after this year.
I thought it was going to happen after last year. I thought that last year would have been the perfect time to take off. At some point, he's going to not be the Alabama head coach. And instead of having to, like, guess and try to come up with – the whole point of the argument is that instead of trying to say, hey, look, let's go do a national search and try to find a guy, you're never going to find another Nick Saban. It just doesn't work out like that. So if you've got – again, you've got two superior coaches around. When you've got two great minds in Kiffin and Sarkisian, no matter what you think about them, no matter what you think about their USC days, these are two phenomenally talented head coaching prospects.
Well, yeah, but it's like having a frat house inside your coaching staff too. I mean, I could imagine that. You know, I mean, they'll get some work done on the weekends.
So again, so if Saban were to leave, then what's your next option up? And then you kind of go out there and you're looking for another head coach to take over that job. Who's going to want to be the guy who has to take over for this?
Well, I mean,
you know,
Dabo would walk or crawl to Tuscaloosa from Clemson.
Maybe, but like even so, Dabo ain't saving. You know, so
no, he's still not. You're right. All right.
So the whole point is that you've got another coach there, so you have everything set up perfectly. If Nick Saban somehow in the next 25 years decides he's not going to be the head coach of Alabama.
All right, Pete. I appreciate you coming on, man. I always enjoy the conversations, even though you got my crowd fired up today. I mean, we were going to have a relaxed day, but not anymore. Thanks, Pete.
Well, I'm not saying he's gone. You got a good team. Have fun with this year. Yes, you know, the world does change. It does happen, yes. Yeah.